Hi everyone, welcome back to Fine Art by Amy. In today's video I'm going to show you how I do the underpainting for my pet portraits using Pan Pastels. As you can see in the picture, there's quite a lot of really deep dark areas and some areas that are quite light as well. The bridge of the nose, on the muzzle and in a lot of the fur. So I'm just going to get right into it and show you how I do my underpaintings. So this is the outline. It's not as detailed as what I would usually do. So I'm going to start off with the lighter colours. So, and this is because I don't want the dark colours to mix in with the light. So this is the pan that I'm going to use. This is called Payne's Grey. I'm just going to rub my eyeshadow applicator over the pan and just mark out where those light areas are. So as you can see, he's got a really nice bright area just coming around his ear here. Now the good thing about doing an underpainting with Pan Pastels is that you don't have to be really, really neat and precise, because you're going to go back in with the coloured pencils, or if you prefer pastel pencils, and tidy everything up. You can also layer the Pan Pastels if you want to get a darker colour, or you can just skim across if you just want a wash of colour. Again, as you can see, I'm not really being neat or precise. It's just all about getting that first layer of colour down, because like I say, you're going to go back in with the coloured pencils and put in that detail. So then I'm going to go in with a slightly darker colour, and this is Raw Umber Extra Dark. The camera will focus. And this is my medium tone colours. And he's quite dark here. Another good thing about the pan pastels is that they are fully erasable. So if you do make a mistake, it's not a problem because you can just erase it. So it's got the same colours just going off down here. Another thing to note is that if this was a commission, I would have erased the outline as well, because you don't want that showing through. And it's dark all the way down here. So as you can see, in this area here, he is really dark. So what I'm going to do is go in with my black. You can blend it out if you wish, just like so. But again, because I'll be going back in with the coloured pencils to put in the detail, I don't tend to blend out too much. So it needs to be a little bit darker, so I'm going to go in for another layer. So with an underpainting, it is more just about blocking in your colours and giving you a bit of a base to start off from. Okay, so that's nice and dark. As I say, you can blend out the edges, because the good thing about pan pastels is that they are really easily blendable. So they're really good for beginners, intermediate and advanced artists. And again, going in with the black, he's quite dark down here. You know, to get really deep, rich darks, particularly black, it would take you a long time to build up that colour just using coloured pencils. It'd take you 4 or 5 layers easily. So the good thing about using the pans is that you're able to build up that dark colour a lot quicker, which is going to save your coloured pencils. It's going to save time. See, as you can see, not being neat at all. Now, if I was using the official soft tools, I wouldn't be creating as much mess, because they were designed to work along with the pan pastels. Going in with the brown, this is burnt sienna shade, because he has got a little bit of brown in his coat down here. Blend those colours together. And again, it's really dark around his muzzle here. And then in his nostrils is dark as well. And then he's got a nice light bit here where the sun has hit his nose. And then it's just mid-tones. Again, not being really neat, it's just about blocking in those colours. It's light across his muzzle. Again with the brown shade, we've got a little bit of brown fur there. More mid-tone here. And he's light here, again where the sun's hit him in the photo, and then again mid-tone the rest of the way. So as you can see, again, I'm really not being very neat. Mid-tone in the middle. white on the outside. Back in with the mid. And he's got a little bit of brown just there. And more black there. So I think I'm going to stop there. As you can see, really, really easy to do. This has taken me less than 20 minutes. And if this was a commission, I would now go back in with my coloured pencils and put in the detail. And you've got a little bit of black just coming from his nose there. Okay, thank you very much for watching. If you liked this video, please subscribe, like, and turn on your notifications. And I will see you next time. Thank you very much. Bye.